On Capitol Hill, lubricant is life itself. For any business to proceed, palms, wheels, and indeed genitals must be well greased and primed for rapid action. The man who cannot command sebaceous moisture to his advantage is left with chafed parts and failed intentions. Conversely, the man who can make the implements of power and pleasure the wettest is king. At the time of this telling, such a king was Republican House Majority Leader, golfer, duck hunter, and staunch Roman Catholic Kent Gaynor. He was highly popular with GOP congressmen, greatly respected in the business community, and even enjoyed a warm friendship with Supreme Court Justice Carmine Fallucci. And yet, despite his many personal and professional boons, Gaynor was a preoccupied man, often staring into space, biting his lip, and twitching his fingers in apparent agitation. At times, he would break off conversation to subtly but distinctly shift in his pants. He was quite possibly a man with secrets. In Gaynor's innermost chamber, behind a locked and soundproofed door, lay one secret: an oil painting. Boldly rendered in sharp lines and slashing colors on the canvas was a man who had sat astride American industry for over 30 years in the mid to late 19th century. He was Tyrus J. Boomwaggle. Boomwaggle the tycoon, Boomwaggle the blusterer, Boomwaggle the merciless czar of glue factories, copper mines, and sugar fields. And why was this painting a secret? Surely it would be acceptable for a GOP leader to have an oil portrait in his office? Undoubtedly a beautiful work of art would raise no eyebrows. Ah, but scandal would rear its head if anyone slipped into the chamber, heard the snorts, wheezes, and intoxicated shouts, and came to realize that Boomwaggle, bound by the edges of his frame, was alive.